have to just go on the basic information. So these are resources from Founders and Pinnell. The one on the left is exactly what it says it is. It shows you kind of where kids fall in each grade level, what their grade level band is. So if you think about kindergarten, we start at A. By the end of the year, we want them at maybe D or E. For grade one, we start at E, and then you go to J, and you can see how it falls. By fifth grade, you're pretty high in the alphabet. The texts are much longer, and you only have them read a certain amount of text. They don't read the entire book. They're going to read just a certain amount of it. Part of that is going to be to themselves. So you have them read, you're going to decode it, and then the rest of the good, they read silently, and you ask them the comprehension questions. So grades 4 and 5, you have a little different system.
Did that be allowed?
Pardon? Did be allowed? A bit of it, so you can kind of get a feel for their decoding and fluency. And then after a unit, you can let them read silently, so it's sort of comprehension. And then we see, we're going to today, when we do the running records, we'll figure out how to find their accuracy and what that means. And you can see that the top one is for levels A through K, and L through N is at the bottom, and it's a little bit different score. And I think that is in your packet as well. All right. So we need to know our students in order for us to create the group. So how well do the, so it's more than this, right? It's more than the data. How well do the kids get along? You're going to kind of get a feel for that starting day one. When they're on the playground, when you have them working in groups those first few days of school, how do they interact? If they don't get along, it's just a headache for you that you don't need. We talked about the targeted instruction based on the data that we have, and that they were fluid, and how to choose the text that they're going to read. So